Hello guys, in this video we'll be attaching a mechanical arm to the top of our Mechanum Wheel robot. This robot is inspired from DJI RoboMaster EP Core and is one of its kind on YouTube. It can be used for various applications. In this video we'll be covering the design and the assembly of the mechanical arm and the servo clock. The chassis of the robot was designed and assembled in the previous video. You can take a look by clicking on the I button. So let's start. This is the CAD model of the robot with all its parts designed separately and have been assembled together. All the parts are 3D printable and it took about 17 hours to print the arm and the claw at 20% infill and 0.2mm layer height. And note that none of the parts of the claw or the arm required support while 3D printing. You can download the files from the website themechninja.com or by simply Google the Mechninja STL files. And then click on the product page. You can choose from a variety of projects. And on clicking on the project, you will receive all the information about the files and the printer settings. And once you download it, you will receive all the printable files required to make the robot. Now let's get back to the assembly work. So here I am using the body of the Mechanum Wheel robot which I made in the previous video. So if you haven't checked it out, then click on the I button and have a look. I have removed the front and the back body panels and the battery of the robot so that we can start the assembly work. The servo claw is made from various small parts which I have 3D printed in black and grey. You can choose the color of the filament according to your design. I have 3D printed these parts from PLA but you can also opt for ABS material. First we will insert the M3 screw of 15mm length into the bottom part as shown. Then I used 4 sets of M3 nut bolts of 10mm length to mount the middle plate to the top part. And don't tighten the nut too much or it may damage the 3D printed part. Now the top part has been completed, I am using an SG90 servo for the claw. You can also use a metal gear servo. The best buy link for the parts is in the description. To fix the servo to the servo plate, I used double sided tape and then later fixed it with 2 long screws. Press it tightly to fix it in position. I have already inserted the plastic servo arm into the arm of the claw and fixed it with super glue. Before placing the servo arm, I used a servo tester to find the perfect angle for the claw. And once you find the perfect angle, place the servo arm in its mount and fix it with its screw. And then test the claw and change its position if it's misplaced. I am using M3 nuts and bolts of 10mm length to mount the remaining pieces of the claw. I am using a nylock nut to prevent the loosening of the nut from vibrations. Now to make the claw, use 2 arms and place the connecting link between them. Then insert a screw between them and tighten it. And make sure that the connecting link is able to move freely between 2 arms with a little resistance. And adjust the resistance by tightening or loosening the nut. Now comes the tricky part, that is assembling all the parts together. So first insert the screws into the holes provided in the middle plate as shown. And then attach both the claw links with the screws. Then attach the other arm to the middle plate using a 10mm screw. Now place both the parts on top of each other and assemble them. Though it's a tricky process, but once the bolts are aligned with the holes, then it's easily assembled. Then fix the remaining parts and the claw is ready to work. I have fixed the servo using 2 long screws of 2mm diameter. Then test the claw with a servo tester. If its grabbing power is not enough according to you, then you can replace the servo with a metal one. Now we'll start the assembly of the mechanical arm. It's made up of 3 parts, the horizontal arm, the vertical arm and the base. I'm using 2 MG995 servo motors to power the mechanical arm. It has a torque of 10 kg cm. The best buy link for the part is in the description. I have used 4 M3 screws of 10mm length to connect the servo motor with the base. While connecting the servo motor, make sure to check its orientation. I wouldn't recommend using a high torque motor until you have one because we are using a plastic frame body and higher torque will be of no use. Now take the round arm of the servo motor and put it in its slots in the vertical arm. Press it tightly as it's a friction fit while maintaining the alignment of the screw holes. Then use 4 screws of 2mm in diameter to fix it in place. Now we'll attach it to the base. So first take a bearing of 10 mm outer diameter and 3 mm internal diameter and place it in the groove provided in the base. But since I'm using an 8 mm bearing, I have to place it in a ring to increase the diameter to 10 mm. Now take a servo tester to fix the position of the vertical arm. So first insert the bearing and then attach the vertical arm with the servo motor. I have already found the perfect angle of the servo as we had done during the claw assembly. Now comes the tricky part of attaching the servo arm screw. So place the screw in its position and then insert the screwdriver from the bearing hole and then tighten it. Then insert the M3 screw into the second hinge. Attach the other servo and check if the bolt is obstructing the servo. If so, then use a flatbed screw. Now attach the other servo with the screws. Its orientation is opposite to that of the first servo. Now take the round servo arm and attach it to a 3D printed arm using 4 screws of 2 mm diameter. And attach it in its position using a servo tester. Once completed, the base assembly will look like this. Now it's time to mount the horizontal arm. So first take the vertical connecting link and fix an M3 nut on top of it using super glue. Now connect it with the base plate using a 10 mm screw. Then take the horizontal arm and place it over the vertical arm and then attach the triangular section beside both the arms using a 15 mm screw. Use a nylock nut and tighten it. Maintain the resistance while tightening the screw. And then attach the other hinge using a 10 mm screw. Now take a flathead screw to connect the vertical link with the triangular section. I prefer the flathead screw over the hex screw because its heads will not create an obstruction during the horizontal arm movement. Now connect the servo link with the servo arm and the horizontal arm using 2 screws of 8 mm and 10 mm length. Now take the horizontal link and connect it with the triangular plate using a flathead screw. Now we'll attach the claw to the mechanical arm. Connect one side of the claw with the 10 mm screw and tighten it. And while connecting the second side, insert a washer between them and tighten the screw. Then connect the horizontal link with the claw using a flathead screw. Now our mechanical arm and claw assembly is completed. Carefully observe the assembly and tighten any screws if there is any loose part. Increase the wire length by using a jumper wire and attach the wire to the wire assembly using zip ties and cut the remaining part. Now we will attach the mechanical arm to the top of the robot frame. So first insert the servo wires into the center hole and carefully pull them from the front section. Use nose plier to carefully pull the wires. Once all the wires are pulled out, match the alignment of the screw holes. Then insert the screw into the holes and tighten it. The wiring of the circuit is done as per the circuit diagram. It is same as that of the previous one, only the servos are installed. The code and app are same as that of the mechanum wheel robot. To view the coding part, click on the I button. Now the final assembly of the robot is completed and it's time to attach the front and the back panels. I connected both the panels using M3 screws of 15 mm length. And since it's an all-terrain robot, you can attach an FPV camera on top of it to view the real-time footage. You can use the 5V output from the robot to power the camera as shown in the wiring diagram. Now the assembly of the robot is completed and we'll test it. So first I will switch it on from the bottom button and then open the Wi-Fi hotspot. And when the robot is connected to the hotspot, then I will insert the IP address which we have generated from the code. All the buttons on the robot work perfectly well, so let's test the mechanical arm. I am testing it by picking up a 250 gram box and hoping that everything works fine. as everything was working perfectly, I tested the lifting capacity of the arm by picking up some weight from it. And I found out its lifting capacity is somewhere about 500 grams. Though it can lift above 500 grams, but above that range, the arm used to vibrate during the robot motion. So 500 grams is the safe limit for a robot. The assembly of the robot is completed and it works smoothly on rough surface. Since it is an all-terrain vehicle, it can move on rough surfaces and can be used for off-roading. But during off-roading, we can't use the mechanism wheel properties because mechanism wheel only works on flat surfaces. So you can make one of the robots for yourself and perform various operations. And if you enjoyed this video, then give it a thumbs up. And also if you have any suggestions, then you can comment in the comment section. So like, share and subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss any upcoming videos. And as I already told you, each project is an upgraded version of my previous one. So don't miss any of them. So till then, you can watch my other videos. And thanks for watching and have a nice day.